happy you came by to see a new video of us. My name is Jani for everyone who is new here, and for all of you who are watching, welcome. Today is a special day because it is the Home Decor Collaboration Day, and if I am correct, you just saw coming by seven beautiful other YouTubers who are joining us in this great Home Decor Collaboration. And of course, before I forget, I'll put a link down below for all of their beautiful channels and of course for the playlist where you find all the beautiful YouTubers with their beautiful home decor. So there will be tons of inspiration, so go check out the playlist. For me today, I am doing the DIY with some rain boots, and of course I'll do a decorate with me. If you like this content, I hope you will consider subscribing to our channel and give it a thumbs up and tick the bell so you will be notified every time we upload our video. So like I said, it was a very chaotic decorate with me, and of course DIY was also a very task because it didn't want to go the way I had it in my head. So I hope you enjoy watching my DIY and my decorate with me, and of course don't forget, if you're done here, go check out the playlist. But for now, let's jump into the DIY. So this is my home decor piece that I will DIY today. You see here, these are some porcelain rain boots. And of course, I bought them on clearance last year. The original price was, this one was $29.95, and this one was $19.95. And I found that a really high price for something like this. So then I bought them in clearance, and in clearance I paid for this one, I paid $9.95, and for the little one $4.95. so this was a little bit better. I thought I found really the price too high for a simple porcelain boot. Of course he is a little bit big, but not for that price. And of course I have decorated it last year with then I made some candle holder from the both of the boots, a big candle holder and a small candle holder. So they were very nice. That I look, and the last time I had them outside of my home, but for now I clean them up and I'm going to paint them because I don't like a little bit of the green, mint green color. Here in the net you call it mint groen, but I think the camera picks it up right. At least I hope so. But for now, this time I'm really have a discussion with myself if I will use the black matte or that I will use the silk gray. So I really don't know if I like a little bit more of the silk gray color or the black matte color. So it is a surprise what it will be. I will try both of them a little bit on the boot. Maybe I can decide then what color I will choose, but they change from color, that's for sure. That's for sure. So let's paint now. So you see here how beautiful my paint my paint corner is looking like. But first I will do some silk on it and a little bit of the black. So I hope the camera picks it up right. You see here, it is a little bit of the creamy gray, light gray color. And now I will do the black. So here you see the black one. So I don't know yet. I have to think about it, which color I will choose. You will see. So it is a surprise which color they will choose. So, and in the meantime, my boots are dry, drying in my garage. I did a little bit of a try of my books to make them black, but they didn't work out. They didn't work out. So I will also paint this one in the black or the silky gray color. So we will see how they will turn out. But you can see already I did a lot of things for the Easter time. I already had here my bunnies on the inside and a centerpiece in the book, in the wooden book. And of course a little bit of the summery touch, but both of them didn't work out the way I planned it. So we will change them also. So you see, I painted the sides of the book with tape, and now I hope this time the paint doesn't go under under the tape. So we will see. So now he's ready to spray paint. So here you see how my rain boots turned out. I think they turned out quite nice. So you see, I'm so happy with the result. So now I only have to decorate them with some greenery, and I will show you now how my books turned out. But I don't know if they really turned out that great, but I already printed out some farmhouse prints, so I will do them on my book on the front and on the back side. So I will show you when that is done, because I know already that you know already what mod podging means, so I don't think I will bore you with that. So I will do the books first, and then I will show you how they are looking like. But I'm very happy with the way my rain boots turned out. So you see, now I did the books with mod podge, and I made it a different print on it. And of course, now we're going to watch if the paint did not go under my paint. I hope it didn't. So far, so good. Now I hope I can get this one out. It's not very easy. You see, this time, the last time with the sign, it did go under the tape, and thankfully this time it didn't. So I'm glad that it didn't go under, or else I had to paint them, and I will distress it a little bit to make it look like an old book. So I will distress it a little bit, but I'm so happy that it didn't go under the tape. So I do the next one, and then we are almost ready to decorate my boots. So you see, now already I have a couple of things ready for my boots. Of course, I will do it a little bit simple, because I have them under my fireplace. I'm not really have a big fireplace like a lot of you are used to, but I have an electric fireplace, and under it I will do the boots and of course the books. So, but first I'm going to use the hydrangeas from IKEA. They were, I think, $12.99, I think. So they are very beautiful. They are really lifelike, so they are really nice. They have them in a couple of colors, I think in the blue one and in the pink one. I wish I did they also had them in the white one, but they don't have them in the white one. So I think I will do this one in this boot. I hope you still can see it with my camera. And of course I will use a little fern also from IKEA. I use in the smaller one, and for the bigger one I still have some ferns just to make it comparable with each other. I do some ferns around my hydrangea so it will come together, so they are belong together. So first we're going to see if I get my hydrangea in my, of course this will be this will be a very task. I don't hope that my boot is going to break, so I hope not. If I have a little bit, so at least he is really stuck. He won't fall out of my boot, that's for sure. But And now I have to see if I get a couple of my ferns. Maybe I show you a little bit how I will do it, and then I will do the other things out of camera, because or else you will be very bored. Of course, this loose ferns are also from IKEA. I just got some plants of this far one, and I really took everything. You can very easily can pull them out, so I pull them out from another plant, so you have a couple of loose pieces, and you just stick them around your plant. Of course, you can use some colors. Here's a little bit of the lighter color. I always love greenery. Now I have to see if I still have another one, so two-piece one. And I hope I still have another one. Of course I have, and I still want to do this one over here. And of course I do a couple of the things them here, because the hydrangea is not really full here within, so I'm just doing a couple of the lighter greens just inside of your hydrangea, so it fills a little bit up and it just makes it comparable with the other fern I will use. But of course you can do any plant or flower you like to do. I will do one over here. I hope I do it when you can see it on camera. I see you can see not really good. I will do it a little bit higher. I'm so sorry. I'm showing you, but you can't even see anything. So, but if you didn't see it, I just use some ferns and I did them on the side. And of course, I do some lighter greens here in the center of my hydrangea. I will show it to you in a moment a little bit closer. So now you can get a really floor arrangement a little bit, and it makes comparable with the one I'm doing in the little boot. You see here. I have to look if I still need one over here. And it's so easy just to pull them in. So if you don't want to buy a lot of greenery, a lot of expensive things, just buy a fern from IKEA for $4.99, and you just can pull them out and you just have a bag full of pieces. You can use time and time again. I use them already more than a year or 2 years, so you can use them for everything. So I think for me this one is already enough greenery, so I will do this one over here. And now I have the smaller boot. Now we will see if I get my fern. Of course he doesn't of course he doesn't fit. I wouldn't, so I will have to squeeze them in. I hope then he will get in, but I'm a little bit afraid that he won't. So I think I have to, but I don't want to pull him out, but I think with the pot itself it doesn't work, so I have to pull them out. So then I will show you. You see here, now you can especially see how easy it is to pull the ferns from IKEA, and you just here, you can just pull them all out. But for now, of course, I don't do that. I just doing this one over here, and I arrange it a little bit, because I now I'm getting it lower in my boot, because if I will, I'm trying to use this won't fit. So So you see, they are fitting with each other right now. So I like that things are fitting with each other. So I show you a little bit closer in a moment. I did the fringe inside of my hydrangeas. So to give it also a little bit of the fullness inside of the hydrangea. And of course, just the simple fern and a simple boot you also can. But I did a while back, I also had an old couple of rain boots, the really rain boots, and I painted them also. So that will work also. So if you have lying around some old rain boots, you still can spray paint them. Just do some newspapers inside of your rain boot. Just spray paint them and leave a little piece on top. Leave a little piece over for with your papers. Then you can make an arrangement also in your old and used rain boots. So don't throw your rain boots away. Just make new ones of it. And of course, I bought this one because they were on sale. But of course, like I said, you can also use your old ones. And now I have my two centerpieces ready. Now I will show you and decorate the little corner by my fireplace. And then I will show you how it looked like. So now I show you a little peek of my cozy corner. Like we say here in the Netherlands, we really have cozy corners, because our houses are, most of the houses here are a lot smaller than a lot of you are used to. So we have really cozy corners. So you see the mess I have on my little table under my electric hearth, like I think you say it that way. But you see here, I have to clean it up, and I really am struggling with how I will have my boots around here, because they are the height is very big. So we have to work a little bit, so how I will have it this way. So, but first I have to clean it up and make a clean sleeve here. So I do that first before I get you along with my decorating. So now I want to show you how I am already busy for a couple of hours, because I always setting up a little bit how I want my corner to be. But like you see here, I will show you, it is one big mess because it didn't work the way I want it to be. So, but I hope I have it now, so I will start decorating the way I think he will look great. So join me. So I hope I don't show my back the whole time, so that you don't see my back the whole time. But I hope you still can see a little bit what I'm doing. So of course, some old little boxes from my freezer. So I use them for a little bit of height, because my little the wooden trunk is a little bit deep. So then you won't show, if you won't see my, I don't know if I look this way or this way, or else I will do them beside each other, because I don't want to, I hope you don't have a lot of I'm sorry for the noise. So I know it's a little bit chaos. It's always with me, always chaos. So you see here, I already did some, and now I put a couple of pieces of fake grass, so it gives a little bit for the seeing, a little bit green, so I don't have to do so much green in it. Of course, you see here already, I have a little, we'll pull it over here. I still hope you can see it. I also have still a buddy here, a sticky gum. But first, a while back, I had the Mackenzie Child print in the back of my wooden trunk. But now I will do a couple of the buffalo check. So I printed out some buffalo check print. So on Google, it's very cheap, and you of course you have to pay for the print, your inked print, but for else it is very, very cheap. But I'm saying right now, it is totally, totally not English every time. But you see, I think you already know what I mean a little bit. So I will do this one at the back of my wooden trunk. So I use a couple of pieces of the sticky gum. So I'm sure that they will stick in the back of my wooden trunk, and you will see how easy it is. Just for a very cheap way, you still can give it a very unique background. Of course, I will do three under, because you don't want that it shows that it is a print. It has to be look like that it's belonging on here. So of course I have to try to get it so flat as I can be, that you don't see that it is just a print. So I still have to need work this one a little bit out, and this one. So you see a little bit what I mean. I see here is a little bit, maybe I need to work this one this way, and a little bit this way, and this one a little bit. So you see, you get in a very easy and cheap way, you get the back of your trunk in a print you want. You can do a tropical print, you can do a coastal print, because that's very in right now, so you can do anything you want. But for now, I will use the Buffalo Check print, and of course I will do my trunk a little bit behind. The only thing I'm a little bit worried about is because I do my black boots herein. I think when they are standing on fake grass, I don't think they are standing that great. So I will try it, but I'm a little bit afraid. That's what I was already afraid of, that he is a little bit, the height is not really very even. So we have to figure that out. So you see here, I have the two boots inside now on the freezer boxes, but I have them attached with some sticky gum because they wouldn't stand right. Of course, because I'm a little bit afraid if they are standing loose that they will fall off. So for now, I wanted to do next to my fireplace, I want to do a wooden box, and I also want to bring a little piece of my print back here. So this one I will do inside of here. So also I do some little touches of the sticky gum behind the piece of paper. It just needed some little pieces. It doesn't have to be a big piece, because it's only have to keep it in the back side of the. So you see here, they are in a very easy way, just a wooden box. And of course, if you have the money and you want to spend the money, I don't want to spend the money, because I'm a person who is changing a lot my decor. So every time, even before I told you earlier, even before I started YouTube, I already changed everything every time. So for me, I find it very necessary to buy every time new decor. So I almost mostly I try to make my own. So I will use this one, and I will show you now. I bought this succulents from IKEA, they were $4.99. Now I'm not correct. They were $2.99 and I bought four of them. So I will place one of them here and now I will place them over here. This is one. And of course I have a second one. Also one over here. And also place one succulent over here. But now first we are going to place my distressed books in my box. Now I still hope they are fitting, and they don't, because a while ago they did, but they don't now. Oh my, this is one of those days that nothing is going to work. So I have to work a little bit with it, but I won't bore you with that. So I see you when I have the books inside of my trunk. So it was no wonder it wasn't fitting, because I didn't have the books the first time flat, but I did have them standing right up. So now I understand why they didn't fit. So you see here, I will use this one over here. I really love my fur, like everyone knows. It gives always such a structure to your decor. So for now, I will do, I have two little lanterns. They are from metal. And now I will do some hydrangea, a little bit to bring out the white touches. So, of course, it doesn't mind that you have the back this way, because you won't see it that way. So I will do one over here, just to give a little pop of white. And I also do it with the second one. And he will be right beside the other one. So of course, also over here, I will do the white hydrangea in. And of course, later I will do a cleaning spray on it, and I will clean the glass up. But this is just for you to see where I will put it. So of course I will put this one over here beside this one. Now I have, this is a very old telephone. I got it from a family member of mine, and I'm so happy with it. But if I would do my way, I would cut this wire off. But I don't do that, because he is still working. He is really real, and he's so heavy. So, but this is one of the first here in the Dutch. He is also the brand from PTT, so that was a brand who delivered the telephones in our time. So I can't cut the wire off, because he's still working. So, but I will use it in my decor. So of course a little bit this way, and I will place my, a little bit at the back, and I will do the wire under my fur, so he won't get in the way. So I still think I want to do it a little bit more. I don't know if I like it this way, or if I really like it this way, but we will see. And of course I have a little bunch of little candles. They are real little candles. I got them on in second-hand store. So I have a couple of them, so I will lay them over here. I hope you can see it with your from the camera out. So now I will place a little planter also over here, but I don't know if I will need a little bit. Like I said, they were from IKEA also, and they were 49 cents, at least here in the Netherlands. So of course you can do the sticker out of it, you can do it in the pot, and you can do it, distress it, you can paint it, you can do anything with it, and you can use it as a height. I don't know if I need a little bit of the height. I have a feeling I do, but I still need a little piece of greenery to give it a little bit of the height here. I still hope you understand where what I'm talking about, because so, and here also a clock from IKEA. They were $5.99 if I am correct. So I will place this one also over here. So now I think this one is a little bit behind this one, a little bit over here, and this one over here, because I did move the trunk a little bit. So now we have to see what kind of greenery I will use. So you see here, I did my plant in here. I had it on a metal planter, but that was a little bit too high. So I hope I have it on the height I want to. So of course, I put some greenery in it, and then you won't show anything in the trunk anymore. So at least not from the bottom off. So I think already I am a little bit with the core pieces. I already have a little bit everything done. I still need to finish off with some eucalyptus branches. And I will put them all in, and I won't bore you with that. So I will put all my greenery in, and then I show you how he's turning out. This was my DIY of my rain boots, and of course the DIY of my wooden books. And of course, I'd love to take you along a little bit in the process of how I decorate my house. Of course, in my house, it is always a chaos, but it is a lovely chaos. And I hope it is a little bit, I always try to make it a unique and a cozy, cozy home. So if you like this content, and I hope you will consider subscribing to Diane and my channel. And of course, go check out the beautiful playlist with all the beautiful creators who are having such a beautiful home decor content. So go check them out and subscribe to their channels and give them also a thumbs up. So for me, I love to say, please take care of yourself, take care of each other, and I wish you all a beautiful day and love from Diane and me. And we really hope to see you in another video. Bye everyone.